Here we go, people. It's Barcelona against Bayern Munich in the Champions League. It's a crazy match in the world's most touted competition. It's Barcelona, for once, who are underdogs coming into the game. We're up against, well, really, the best team in Europe, in my opinion. It's as simple as that. They just are the best team in the world right now. And winning the Champions League this season for Barca will be extremely, extremely tough. We'll be talking a little bit about that later. But guys, we're here for the ride. We're right behind the team. So let's get started with the match preview. And this game will be coming to us live from the Estádio da Luz in Portugal, Lisbon, that is. It's going to be Benfica Stadium. We're at the neutral grounds now. We're in Lisbon, 8 p.m. UK time, that is. I think that's, is it 9 Portugal time? It might even be 8 Portugal time, actually. I'm not entirely sure how the time zones work over there. But either way, 8 p.m. for you UK viewers, that will be on BT Sport. And it's quarterfinal time, guys. We're at the neutral venues now. And that really makes this anyone's game. That probably is something that plays into our favour, I would say. You know, say it's over two legs, we have to go to Munich, then back to Barcelona or something. You know, you would think over 180 minutes Bayern would have the better of us. But, you know, let's just hope in this 90-minute game, no fans, one-off stadium, we can pull something out of the hat here. And let's start with our Barcelona here because, well, we're in the quarterfinals yet again. But, hey, we offer falter at this exact round, and around this sort of stage is where Barcelona seem to slip off. And this year, guys, is going to be much harder than any of those other years where we have faltered. And, well, if we want to win the Champions League this year, we're basically going to have to beat Bayern Munich or get past them, then get past Manchester City, and then face probably the PSG or Atletico Madrid in the final. And, hey, this isn't even our strongest squad. This is not our strongest squad in the last decade. It may even mean our weakest right now. You know, you wonder whether the player profiles fit in any formation. I don't really know if the manager's good enough. We've had a really poor year. And right now, the Champions League winning it, it just seems almost unthinkable. But we are here, guys. We have a chance. You know, we're not that many games away. Just 3 90-minute matches now away from winning the Champions League. And that's also what we've got to keep in mind, guys. We are close now. There's certainly pressure on us, you know, it's not going to be easy, like I just said, we've got all these teams to play against, but we're closer than maybe we think. And like I said, there is going to be pressure on Barcelona. We do not want to have a trophy this season. It will be one of the first, you know, in a recent decade, really. And, well, for Barcelona, me as a fan, I haven't really experienced many of those, but it's just one of those things that happens, guys, and it does look like this is ultimately going to be a trophy this season, but it may not. If we win this, it will be an absolutely crazy season, guys. And honestly, you know, what a weird moment that would be. What an amazing moment it would be. It's also important to note, though, that there almost isn't pressure, as we almost go into this game as essentially massive underdogs, honestly. You know, like I say, Bayern Munich, we're not favourites there. Playing against Man City, we're probably not favourites there. And in the final against PSG or Atletico, I'd put us down as favourites. But, you know, even then, we could definitely easily lose to either one of those two sides. So, you know, we've got some massive, massive games ahead of us, and maybe even just one. We may be tossed out to Bayern here quite easily. But, you know, for me, we're just such massive underdogs for this trophy, and we've really got to step up for this game. Just looking back to our last game here against Napoli, guys, for me, we just weren't really that good, you know. The second half especially, it's just not good enough. It really isn't, you know. The positive is that we did our job in our low block. We kept it, you know, nice and tight back there. But my God, we will need to improve the fitness levels for this one. And I was just watching Atalanta last night in the Champions League and a few other teams in the Europa League. And fitness needs to be discussed at this level, guys, because certain teams cannot keep up for 90 plus minutes in the competition. You saw Atalanta yesterday. They were flat out on their feet, and PSG just picked them off with two easy goals in the late minutes that should not be happening. And Barcelona, you saw that against Napoli. We came out to the second half with nothing left in the tank, and we've got to have a massive performance here against Bayern Munich if we want to get through. You know, we've got to be fit, we've got to be patient, super hard working, clinical in front of goal when we get the chances. We've got to rely on Messi and Suarez here to get some massive finishes for us. And honestly, we've got to say we trust them for these sort of occasions. But it almost needs to be a perfect 90 minutes from Barcelona in order to progress. But it is also important to note that we can't just be written off. You know, we do have Messi. We are still Barcelona. And even though this seems like one hell of a task, maybe even our hardest game in the last, well, decade really, guys. Have you ever come into a game feeling this inferior? As a Barcelona fan, I'm not sure I have in my lifetime, if I'm being honest with you guys. So, yeah, this is a massively tough game, but we are here to win it. We're not here to take part. We're not here to show the world how good Bayern Munich are. We're here to beat them and get through. But like I just mentioned earlier, guys, we do need to see improvement in the team. It's not as simple as just saying, hey, we're going to come here and beat Bayern Munich, because, honestly, it doesn't look like we will right now. But, you know, I trust the squad to give it their all. They've really got to give it all their all for this 100% effort from everyone. And we'll go into, you know, this game with everything needing to be right. The lineup needs to be right. You know, you look at the manager on the sideline, Setien, is a key talking point I wanted to mention. I've written down here, we need Setien, guys. We need our manager to help us, to be brave, to guide us through the game. You know, our bench is much stronger than the one against Napoli. It really is. He's got a lot more options now, and he has to use them. And he has to use them early. I don't want to see us 2-1 down, and then in the 85th minute, he tosses on Ansu Fati and the Diki and Dembele. I want them on in the, you know, the 60th, the 70th minute, if the time is right. And he's got to be braver. He has to make some big calls in this one, else we will be going out here. But let's move on to Bayern Munich now, guys. And this is a part of the video that we just have to do. And unfortunately, you're just going to have to stick around and listen to this because, well, Bayern Munich are essentially brilliant. You know, they're the best team in Europe, like we mentioned in the intro, guys. Even though, you know, say we beat them 3-0 tomorrow, it wouldn't change for me. They're the best team in Europe. They are the best. And Lewandowski has been on ridiculous form. But I want to talk about their whole team. It's just one heck of a well-oiled machine, guys. They are absolutely immense. Ever since Hansi Flick came in as the coach, they just haven't looked back. You know, they know their jobs. They know their roles. They're completely confident. They're an extremely fit side. They're super strong in there. And they're also, they're great footballers. They're not just animals in there. They got great quality, especially in attack and also in that midfield. You know, they got great, great tactics on the sidelines, it would appear. They all know what they're doing. They're very solid, quite hard to break down, immense in attack, and there's not really any other words you can use them other than the fact that, well, they are a wonderful team. Beating them would be an absolutely immense feat for Barcelona here, and there isn't really anything else to say other than the fact that, well, Bayern are just brilliant. They are favourites for the whole competition. They're favourites for tomorrow's game, and Barcelona will need to be working super hard to stop them here. It needs to be 90 minutes of hard work, everyone doing their jobs, stopping the crosses, coming out and meeting the ball, pressing really high, getting in their faces, making things so hard for them, and even them, they could beat us. So, you know, even with almost a perfect Barcelona performance, we could be going out here. And it doesn't, you can't really say that for many other teams, but this Bayern Munich side are so good, it's going to be so hard. You know, let's see what we can do against them, guys. It is, you know, worth noting that if Barcelona do pay them too much respect, I know I'm literally, you know, giving them the big in here and saying how brilliant they are. They are, but we also do need to note that if we're just doing this in the tactics room before and saying how wonderful they are, we'd already be out before we step out on the pitch. We still are Barcelona. We're not coming here to, you know, just admire them, to look and show everyone how good they are. We're here to go and beat them, guys. And it's also important to note that it is actually possible to do that. So let's move on to the lineup, some team news, some tactics. I'm going to talk about a few things here. Let's start with some team news first, though, guys. Barcelona, Busquets is going to be returning. Vidal is going to be returning. Dembele is going to be returning, I think, just to the bench. And Bayern Munich are going to have Kingsley Coman back. But Pavard is still going to be out, meaning that Kimmich in the midfield is going to have to drop to right back, meaning that Goretzka and Thiago make up the midfield. But let's start with the Barcelona lineup, guys. And this is what I've got on screen. This lineup right here, like what I did against Napoli, is the lineup I think we're going to see tomorrow. I'm going to go through it player by player and say what I would do and what I think about it. It's a 4-4-2. I wouldn't usually agree with this, but it is Bayern Munich, guys. We want to get through here. You know, we're not here to, you know, do some little, like, experiment. We want to get through. And if I'm being fair, I think this may be the best way of doing it. A 4-4-2, everyone doing their jobs, working back. But we've got to make sure we actually have something going forward. It can't just be a block and then hope that Messi does something. Messi needs support. Messi needs runners. He needs pace in the attack. He needs options with him. And if I'm being honest, I look around at that lineup and I don't actually see any of those things. That's what worries me. So let's begin, guys. So Stegen in goal, of course. You know, we need him to have a massive game tomorrow, can I just say. Right back Semedo, we need him to be on absolute form tomorrow. And I want to talk about both fullbacks. What we need from them is to really be diligent out there. Watch the runners. Watch the overlaps. Keep tight to your men. Don't let Bayern Munich just whip balls into the box. You know how good Piqué and Longley are at dealing with those, but Semedo and Alaba, especially Alaba, he needs to get closer to the ball. When they have the ball on the right-hand side or on the left-hand side in Semedo's case, come out and meet the player, please. I don't want to see Bayern Munich with constant space down the flanks, and having the likes of Roberto and Arturo Vidal will massively help us stop that threat. But in defence, Piqué and Longley, honestly, one of the best centre-back partnerships in Europe for me. We should not be conceding as many goals as we have been this season with those two. I don't know what was going on half the season, but hey, they're there now. They're brilliant for me, and we need them to have another massive display here against Bayern Munich. Just spoke about Jordi Alba there, guys. Please, he needs to be better at stopping crosses, and he could actually do with helping Messi in attack today because there isn't much else going forward. And then moving into that midfield, guys, I would slightly be tempted to bring Griezmann into the midfield, move Arturo Vidal over to the right-hand side, and move Griezmann to the left-hand side. And I'll say why that is. One, I think Griezmann is probably, maybe not as hard-working as Roberto, but similarly hard-working. He's got a great engine in him. And also, he offers quite a lot going forward. Griezmann, when he has the ball, you know, we can actually then at least transition into more of a 4-3-3 when we have the ball. When we're out the ball, Griezmann can tuck in and help block Kimmich and Gnabry down the right-hand side. For me, that could work. But what we are going to be seeing, I think, is Roberto and Semedo doubling up here, Vidal and Alaba doubling up on the other side, and then Busquets and De Jong controlling it in the middle. I just would be tempted to play Griezmann there instead of Roberto, maybe, just for transitions, really. Roberto is quite good in transitions. We saw that in like, the Clasicos and stuff. He doesn't mind that role, but I just wonder whether Griezmann in a big game, you know, if Messi wants options to pass to, if he wants someone to think, who can I get in on goal here, who's going to score for us, maybe Griezmann's that man. That's just was my thought behind that. Then there's also other players we're missing out. Dembele, where does he fit? In a 4-4-2, where we need to be so hard-working, he doesn't fit in this lineup. Dembele only really fits if he wants some pace, if he wants some energy in the last stages, then I'd bring him on, maybe even up front, to be fair. I don't really know how much I trust him to track back and be really good. I do trust Roberto and Vidal and Griezmann to do that, so Dembele doesn't really fit there. Ricky Puig, again, he fits, but only in a 4-3-3, really. I wouldn't play him in a double pivot with Busquets and De Jong there. Ricky could come on later if we need some legs or you know, creativity, and I would definitely be bringing him off the bench. And then Ansu Fati, guys, you know, these are the sort of players that every preview I come in and say they have to start, but it's probably the one game I wouldn't really start them in. It's whether you go out and be brave at Barcelona, and it's a real, really, real limbo, this one, because part of me is saying, you know, go out there, play in the 4-3-3, get Ansu on the pitch, get Ricky on the pitch, and then part of me is just saying, you're going out if you're doing that. And it's just a balance there, guys. It's worth noting that Setien isn't going to play Ansu, he isn't going to play Ricky, he's going to play what's on your screen right now, guys. And that's that. So we've got to try and get behind it. I hope it's what we need to get through. Messi and Suarez up front. You know, Messi, we need an epic performance from him. The good thing about playing 4-4-2 is it suits Messi much more. This is Messi's perfect role. He can come up wide if he wants. He can go wherever he wants in the attack, really. And he's got Suarez up there, almost like a billboard to just play balls into and then get them back off. And Suarez has got a massively occupied Boateng today. We need Suarez to bully him, and I back him to do that. So I hope I've gone through the lineup easily enough for you guys. Like I say, there are a few different variants you could go for. You could easily switch to a 4-3-3 and bring the likes of Griezmann in there, Dembele in there, Ansu Fati. And also you look at the likes of, you know, Ricky Puig back there. There could be options in that midfield. But if we're looking at what we're going to see on the pitch tomorrow night by 8 o'clock, I think that's what we're going to be seeing. For Bayern Munich, there isn't as much to talk about. There aren't really any debates. This is basically their 11, I think, we're going to be seeing. Neuer in goal, Kimmich at right back, probably a plus to us. He can still create from there, but he is one of the best midfielders in the world, so having him at right back instead of CDM is probably better for us. Boateng and Alaba at centre back. And I want to just stop here, guys, because that isn't the best centre back partnership in the world. It really isn't. It's good enough. It probably will win Bayern the Champions League. But it's down to Barcelona to make sure that doesn't happen, guys. We can get at that centre-back partnership. And you're looking at Messi and Suarez up against the likes of Boateng. I think we've got them. I honestly do. I saw the likes of like Tammy Abraham up against Boateng the other night. And Hudson-Odoi even. And just a little turn of pace, you know, a little bit of energy. And you can actually get at them. So, you know, we've got Lionel Messi here for crying out loud. Get at him. I want Messi on Boateng. I want Messi dazzling Boateng. He's not the same player. And even when he was, Messi spun him back and forward and then chipped it over Neuer. So we can get at Boateng tomorrow night. It's just whether that 4-4-2 is actually going to create Bayern any issues at all. You look at the players there, Roberto Vidal. Are they going to hurt Bayern Munich? I don't know. The only player in that lineup I really see hurting Bayern is Messi. Maybe Suarez if he has a good day, but that's my issue with our lineup. It's good out of the ball. I don't know how good it is in the ball, but left-back Davies, I think, is going to be fit. You know, what a player he is. In midfield, Thiago will be partnering Goretzka now because of the injury to Pavard, of course, meaning that Kimmich drops to right back. And then they've got that wonderful front four of Koeman, who's going to be returning instead of Perisic, who started and scored against Chelsea. Gnabry on the right, Müller in the middle, and Lewandowski up front. It's a ridiculous attack. Like I say, we need all the midfield coming out to help out. Pressure on the ball. Don't give them time. Don't give them space. They'll be running in behind our defence at all times. You know, it's going to be such a hard game, guys, but that lineup is immense. The Barcelona one, like I say, I'm stuck whether we try and hurt them or whether we just try and not get hurt ourselves. It's a difficult game. It's going to be such a hard one. And, well, let's go on to the prediction. Because if I was to be fair, guys, and go for an outside view, I'd have to go with a Bayern win here. You know, probably a 2-1 or something. They are favourites. They'll feel really confident here. But it's worth noting, guys, that Barcelona can win here. I want to see us fighting, giving absolutely everything for this one, because this is all we've got now. From now on to the end of the season, this is all we've got. We've lost La Liga, we've lost the Cup, we even lost the Super Cup. We've got nothing left, guys. This is it. It really is. It's going to be an immense game, in my opinion. I'd love to watch this one as a neutral, honestly, but I think it's going to be a really good game. Don't count Barca out, honestly. Bayern are massive favourites here, but Setien, he has to use his bench. He has to be brave. He has to use it early as well. And honestly, we'll need everything for this one. I think I've covered everything there, guys. Quite a long preview for this one. Lots to talk about. I'll see all you guys at the end of the game. And yeah, there's going to be a lot to talk about in the review. Is it going to be a happy one for us Barcelona fans? Imagine if we get past Bayern Munich. Lots to come. I'll see you guys then. Enjoy yourselves. Leave all your thoughts in the comment section down below. Enjoy this brilliant game. And goodbye.